The following is a production of the University of Minnesota.
We know that even within the last 5 years, just Minnesota alone, we've had 206 16 to 19 year olds killed on Minnesota roads.
Car crashes are the leading cause of death for teenagers, with speeding, distractions, and failure to use a seatbelt as major factors behind the high fatality rate.
When you look at the teen driving population, they are clearly overrepresented in our fatalities on our roadways.
We dug into the data to find out why that is, and oftentimes it's because of distraction associated with inexperience at driving. Those two together create often fatal outcome.
And I'm concerned that we are losing the future of Minnesota with these so many teen fatalities.
But researchers at the University of Minnesota's Intelligent Transportation Systems Institute are developing technology to combat the problem. Meet the Teen Driver Support System. It may look like your average smartphone, but there's a lot more behind the screen. It's actually a sophisticated driver feedback system. The TDSS is intended as a tool for parents to assist teens in building safe driving habits in their early years on the road.
Okay, for this specific system, it's mostly smartphone-based, so we get the GPS and acceleration from the smartphone. And then connected to the vehicle, we have the OBD2 Bluetooth connection that gives us speed. And inside we have a small little microprocessor that reads the seat belts and the seat occupancy. So that's pretty much the components of the system.
Studies have shown that teens are less likely to get into crashes when driving with parents, but parents can't always ride along. That's where the TDSS comes in. Mounted on the dashboard, the device provides the young driver with real-time visual and audio feedback, including warnings if they commit infractions. Other phone functions are disabled while the car is on and the TDSS is in use. All incoming calls are routed to voicemail, and no outgoing texting or calls are possible, except to 911 emergency services. The system begins protecting teens before they even pull away from the curb. The car can't be put into drive unless seatbelts are buckled, and the driver will be warned if there are other passengers in the car in violation of the Minnesota Provisional License Law.
Please fasten your seatbelt. Vehicle cannot be put into drive until seatbelt is fastened. Two unauthorized passengers detected. Parents will be notified if you drive with passengers.
Exceeding the speed limit, aggressive maneuvering, and failing to stop at stop signs are just a few actions that will draw a warning.
Exceeding speed limit. Reduce speed now.
And if the teen continues to drive dangerously, the device can take advantage of an especially effective enforcement method. It automatically sends a text message to notify parents.
This particular tool is going to equip parents with the information they need to play the role of parent and monitor their teen driving behavior. And I think it's a good reminder for teens just what is putting themselves at risk. I think that they're learning how to drive, they're learning to take on this responsibility, and by getting feedback immediately after their driving experience, they themselves can raise their awareness about the kinds of behaviors that they need to modify, that they need to be aware of.
This research hopefully will provide us with the ability to minimize distractions to younger drivers, allowing them to pay more attention to the road and ultimately being a safer driver.
There is no single solution to the challenge of reducing teen driving fatalities, but technology like the TDSS offers a promising 21st century tool to combat a tragic problem.